we're going to learn the difference between inner core electrons and what are called valence electrons. So what we're going to say here are valence electrons are basically the electrons we found in the outermost shell. And the outermost shells are usually the electron orbitals with the biggest number. Now, valence electrons are going to become more important when we move over to bonding, when we have to draw chemical structures. We have to realize there that all the bonds that we use to form chemical bonds are using valence electrons. Now, we're going to say that main group metals, whatever your main group metal number is, that's also the number of valence electrons that element has. What do I mean by this? Well, for example, lithium is in group 1A, so lithium has one valence electron. So we're going to say for main group metals, we're going to say valence electrons, so the number of valence electrons equals group number. So these guys would have one valence, these guys would have two valence, three valence, four valence, five, six, seven, and eight valence electrons, except for helium. Helium would have two valence electrons. So that's just for main metals. Now, we know that the periodic table is not made up of only main metals. The periodic table is also made up of transition metals. And when it comes to transition metals, they kind of mess up everything. And for that part, most professors seldom ask for the number of valence electrons of a transition metal. But if they were to ask you the electron configuration or valence electrons of a transition metal, you just have to remember, for the most part, we can figure out the number of valence electrons of these transition metals here. The lanthanides and the actinides down here, because they have F electrons, F orbital electrons, we'd have to use quantum theory in order to solve the number of valence electrons. This is just Chem 1, so you don't have to do quantum theory. So if they're going to ask you a number of valence electrons for transition metals, it would be these transition metals in here. And we'd simply say that their number of valence electrons, so for transition metals, these transition metals, we're going to say number of valence electrons equals number of electrons in the S and D orbitals. And when by S, I mean the highest numbered S, the largest S orbital numbered, and also the D orbital. Take those two, add them together, and that would give us our total number of valence electrons.